YouTube fan, I have a serious question for you. What do you think is the most innovative design of all time? Is it the one that flipped the script and defied conventions? Or is it the one that unveiled a totally new aesthetic? Or maybe an innovation or a technology that found new methods to bring you high quality and high performance? The word innovation is thrown around pretty loosely in the sneaker industry these days. And sometimes innovation ends up being an empty buzzword or a gimmick that sells a couple pairs of sneakers. But in hindsight, it just doesn't hold up as having truly broken new ground. So what is true innovation? Visible air bubbles in the sole, or maybe a computer inside of a shoe? Or how about a built-in pump, allowing the wearer to inflate the shoe to the perfect fit? How about a shoe that is the pump? It's hard to tell what's actually a revolutionary idea and what's a marketing ploy. But today, we're taking a look at one shoe that defied all conventions and undeniably broke new ground for the industry. I'm talking about the Reebok Instapump Fury. Yo, 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 what is up, everybody? Welcome back to the Sneaker Enthusiast Podcast. Sneaker Enthusiast Podcast, what am I thinking? I'm not doing a podcast, I'm doing a YouTube video. Welcome back to the channel, guys. My name is Brian, and if you're new here, my brother Nacho and I make videos on sneaker history and all things related to sneaker culture. So if you're into sneakers, you might want to consider subscribing to this channel so that way you don't miss any episodes that we upload in the future. You notice I messed up on the intro and I talked about a podcast. That is because we do have a podcast here. We do have a podcast, me and Nacho. It's called Sneaker Enthusiast, and we actually interviewed both Paul Litchfield, the inventor of the pump, the Reebok pump, and Stephen Smith, the guy who designed this shoe, and you're gonna hear a lot about in the next couple of minutes, few minutes of this video. So just wanted to throw that out there. That's my plug for the day. Sneaker Enthusiast Podcast. You can find the link to it in the description below. It's available on SoundCloud, iTunes, Spotify, TuneIn, Pandora, anywhere you get podcasts, you could find Sneaker Enthusiast Podcast, and you could listen to me and Nacho talk to these guys and pick their brains about and just go deeper into the history of things like this. So with that being said, guys, plugs out of the way, let's get into the history of the Instapump Fury. Early in the days of Reebok's Advanced Concepts design team, while working on the initial design for the successor to the Reebok pump, Reebok designer Paul Litchfield showed Stephen Smith a design that incorporated an internal air bladder, much like the original Reebok pump. The idea was to build the shoe and slip the pump inside of the shoe. When Stephen saw the shoe, he said, "Why are we building a shoe and then putting this thing in it? Why don't we make it the shoe somehow?" Stephen started cutting out windows on the exterior of the shoe until they ended up with a laceless running sneaker whose exterior was largely composed of the air bladder itself. The design team showed this prototype to Paul Fireman, the head of Reebok North America, and that was all the proof that Fireman needed. He gave the Reebok Advanced Concepts design team what Stephen Smith called a carte blanche to innovate. Fun fact, when we interviewed Stephen for the podcast, he actually told us a really cool story about Paul Fireman, and he kind of basically seeded the idea to the Reebok Advanced Concepts teams for this shoe, and I will share that with you guys now.
Yeah, so in one of those classic Fireman meetings, we're talking about, you know, we're showing like the carbon fiber, we're showing the pump, we're showing the early DMX parts, and Fireman's like, guys, I got this vision. And we're like, yeah. He goes, dude's at the Olympics. He's in the blocks getting ready to do the 50-yard dash. And we're like, there's no 50-yard dash at the Olympics. And everybody's like, don't stop him. He's on a roll. And he's like, so the guy's at the start of the 50-yard dash. He's in the blocks, the sprinter. And they're about ready to fire the starting gun. He goes, well, hold up. And he pulls out this thing and goes, psh, psh, and inflates his spikes. And then he gets back in the blocks and bam, wins the gold medal when the gun goes off. We're like, oh, that's really cool. And he's like, now go do it. And we're like, what? And he goes, go make it happen. I just told you what you need to do. And so it was always amazing ideas like that. You know, he would throw this stuff at you, at these challenges, and we'd go do it. We'd figure out how to do it. And out of that came the Instaflate. All the track and field spikes that use the Instapump bladders.
The design team traveled around the world to source their materials. They visited the aerospace industry, companies building stealth fighters. In fact, speaking of the stealth fighters, that's actually how they sourced the carbon fiber plate that you see on the bottom of the shoe. If you look at the bottom of the Instapump Fury, There's a giant exposed carbon fiber plate that you can actually touch. Similar to that of a Jordan 11, but this one is actually more exposed and you can actually see it. It's very cool. Since we're on the topic of aircrafts, just to give you an idea of how innovative the Reebok Advanced Concepts team really was, they actually took inspiration from, well, they didn't take inspiration, they took the actual materials from helicopter blades and put them into a new cushioning system that Reebok was calling Hexalite. And that's that honeycomb air window thing that you see on Reebok shoes. That's called Hexalite. So I thought that was very cool and I wanted to share that with you guys. The Reebok pump air bladders themselves came from emergency life vests from airplanes. Taking the approach of fewer parts, better quality, the Reebok design team could afford these aerospace materials. They cut down the number of parts in a shoe from typically 150 to, say, 25, saving tons of money on all the parts they cut out and putting that budget towards these higher quality materials on the few parts that they actually did need for the Instapump Fury. And the results of that was one of the lightest running shoes in the world at the time. In countless interviews, Steven makes it clear that a lot of his approach to sneaker design was informed by his punk rock attitude. A common story that you might know that's affiliated with the Instapump Fury and Stephen Smith is the story behind the colorway. And I'm gonna play you guys a clip now of Steven telling that story as he often does in interviews, and it's a really cool story. Check it out.
So we showed it and the marketing guys, who were very conservative, was like, yeah, that'd be great. You know, we could sell it if you did it in blue, gray, and black. So I went home that night and I took a pair into my basement and I spray painted it with gray primer, the entire shoe. And I brought him in the next day and threw him on his desk. I'm like, is this what you want? And, oh, that's perfect, I can sell that. And I'm like, you don't get it, do you? You don't get it, you don't understand it.
We actually had to go to Paul Fireman and kind of plead for his support to launch this colorway. I think what's super important is that having that conviction and keeping yourself true to the project and the project objective, that's where you can create product that people really get intrigued by.
As is becoming tradition here on the show, there are too many colorways to talk about. And I'm not gonna go through every single one because everybody and their mom has collabed on this silhouette, but let's talk about some of our favorites. And let me know what are some of your favorites in the comments down below. I'd love to hear them. There's a super rare Chanel collab, and the rapper Future actually did a hybrid of the Instapump Fury and the Reebok Kamikaze, and they called it the Furikaze. Jackie Chan was actually a huge moment for the Instapump Fury back in 1998. He got his own collab. Vetmol did two Fury collabs, the Graffiti 2.0 and the Monogram. And there are even Jurassic Park, Toy Story, and Minion Instapump Furies. You can call me crazy, but I would definitely rock some Minions or some Toy Story Instapump Furies. I think they're super cool. Here's some of my favorites though. The Reebok Instapump Fury Millennium, which comes in the original metallic bronze or black on black colorway that was introduced with the 2019 Retro. I also love this collab with the Japanese artist Takeyuka Kamioka. Super clean. Notable Chinese sneaker shop Deal designed two dope yin and yang inspired collabs of the Instapump Fury, both sporting different colorways between the left and the right shoe. They dropped two different designs, one from 2017 and one from 2019. Okay, now this is a super interesting one. The collab with the French luxury fashion brand Maison Margiela. I'm pretty sure I butchered that and Vetmo earlier, but yeah, Maison Margiela, is that it? Sporting a tabby style split toe and a boot-like high top, this Fury collab comes in two silhouettes, one with a high heel and one with the flatter, chunkier sole. All the subscribers of this YouTube channel are probably gonna be rocking those high heel Instapump Furies, right? Nah, I'm kidding. Shout out to people like Trinidad James who can pull that off though. That's crazy. I couldn't rock heels as a dude though. Sorry. Here's one of the biggest and perhaps the most unexpected collaborations ever. Since Adidas bought Reebok, they made an Instapump Fury Boost collab with Adidas. Released in 2019, this line of Furies utilizes Adidas Boost padded mesh paneling for the upper. The removable elastic bands boast the brand's name of both Reebok and Adidas, which is kind of crazy. The crazy thing about this collab is it's both Adidas and Reebok on the same shoe, which is kind of unprecedented. You've never seen that. You've never seen like Nike and Adidas on one shoe. It's kind of wild. But between me and you, Adidas owned Reebok. I heard they're trying to sell it, or I don't know what the deal is with that. Master P was talking about buying it. Please buy it, Master P. That would be amazing. But yeah, it was Adidas and Reebok branding on the same shoe, which is kind of wild. And I kind of want to get a pair just for that. So I want to know, have you guys ever worn a pair of Instapump Furies, and are they comfortable? Because I am thinking about buying one of those OG Stephen Smith punk rock colorways for myself. So please leave it in the comments. I would love to know. Thank you guys so much for watching. That is going to do it for the history of the Instapump Fury. I hope you enjoyed that one. Please be sure to check out the podcast with Stephen Smith and also the podcast that we did with Paul Litchfield, the inventor of the pump. We go way, way deeper on this stuff, and they talk about it in a more articulate and more obviously educated way, and I think you would really learn and really appreciate this shoe more if you heard Steven talk about it. So check out our podcast. I'll put a link in the description. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm gonna put a playlist here of all our you know what, I'm gonna put the Reebok pump video right there for you to check out. Boom, Reebok pump history, very in-depth video that I'm proud of, me and Nacho did. Check it out. I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace. See you soon.